welcome to another video in our series of Microsoft Office 365 technical support modules. In this video, I'll show you how to troubleshoot problems you or your users might experience with non-functioning or poor quality audio and video in Microsoft Lync Online. We'll look at three potential problems: choppy, tinny, or delayed audio and video, errors when you try to start audio or video in a one-to-one or group conference, and issues with Lync Online caused by your on-premise firewall. You or your users may sometimes find that the audio or video in a Lync Online conference is choppy, tinny, or delayed. There are several possible causes for this problem, such as latency in the network connection, or issues with the video and audio devices or device drivers. In Lync Online 2010, the conference window displays an audio and video quality indicator to let you know how well you can be heard and seen. If the audio or video quality is particularly poor, you can click the indicator for more information. You may also see a pop-up window alerting you to a particular problem, such as poor network connectivity, a low bandwidth connection, or poor audio quality from a particular device. If you experience choppy, tinny, or delayed audio in a Lync Online conference, there are some steps that you can take to troubleshoot the issue. First, if the computer is using a wireless internet connection, try switching to a wired connection if possible. Wired connections typically have higher bandwidth and greater stability. If you're connecting through a proxy server or from behind a firewall, make sure that the proxy and firewall have port 443 open to all traffic over the TCP protocol, and ports 3478 and 50000 to 59999 open to all traffic over the UDP protocol. Next, you should check the audio settings. Sign in to Lync Online and click the gear icon in the upper right corner. Next, click the Tools menu and then click Options. Click the Audio Device tab and then make sure that the correct audio device is selected. You can see a full list of Lync Online compatible devices here. On the Audio Device page, adjust the microphone slider until the indicator is around the midway point when you speak at your usual voice level. Click OK to save your changes, and then start your Lync Online conference again. When your users try to start audio or video in a one-to-one or group conference in Lync Online, they may experience a failed connection or one of these error messages. The first thing you should do to troubleshoot these problems for your users is to open the Lync Online control panel by signing in to the Microsoft Office 365 portal and then clicking Manage under Lync Online in the Microsoft Office 365 section. Next, click User Information. Click the user who's experiencing problems and make sure that the Enable Audio and Video checkbox is selected. If the problem continues, the issue may be with the internet connection on one or more of the computers in the conference. Make sure that each computer has a working internet connection, such as a direct wired connection, a virtual private networking connection, a Wi-Fi connection, or a direct internet home office connection. If possible, retry the conference with a different type of internet connection. For instance, if a user connects via a wireless internet connection while on the move, they may appear to be online during the conference when they're actually between two different wireless access points and disconnected. Remember that a direct wired connection is the most likely to be stable and have the bandwidth necessary for good quality audio and video during a conference. Next, determine the scope of the issue by trying to reproduce the problem with different users and connections. For instance, the problem may be limited to two particular users communicating with each other, to a single user communicating with anyone, to all users with a specific type of internet connection, or to all users across your domain. Once you've identified the computers where the problem appears to be originating, install and run the latest version of the Microsoft Online Services Diagnostics and Logging Support Toolkit, also known as MOSDL, on each computer, to check their network connections. You can install MOSDL by visiting the download.microsoft.com website and searching for MOSDL. Open the MOSDL Support Toolkit from the Start menu, select the language that you want, and then click Next. Next, click Wizard Mode. Select Data Collection and Network Diagnostics Mode, choose the O365 region, and then click Next. Close Lync Online, and then restart it and reproduce the issue. When the issue has been reproduced, click Generate Report. When the test finishes, which can take a few minutes, Click to open the Mozdul log file storage location in your Documents folder. Open your Reports folder and review the meet.lync.com results for the Office 365 data center in the Network Ping, Network NS Lookup, and Network Tracer T folders. Latencies greater than 200 milliseconds will adversely affect audio and video in Lync Online. Finally, open the Network Port Query folder and check the results for the meet.lync.com website against port 443. Port 443 should be open to all traffic. If your organization has an on-premise firewall, you or your users might sometimes experience problems using Lync Online in your Office 365 environment. For instance, users may be unable to connect to Lync Online, or they may find that presence updates, contact pictures, file transfers, audio and video, and integration with Microsoft Outlook don't work in Lync Online. This can happen if your on-premise firewall is configured in such a way that it blocks the communication flow through the Microsoft Online service. To fix this problem, you should create an allow rule in your on-premise firewall with the following criteria. First, the rule should enable outgoing connections for all MicrosoftOnline.com, all Outlook.com, and all Lync.com destinations. Secondly, the rule should have port 443 open to all traffic over the TCP protocol, and ports 3478 and 50000 to 59999 open to all traffic over the UDP protocol. Finally, the rule should have the HTTPS SSL timeout period set to 8 hours, and be applied to all users in your environment. When you've created the rule, ask your users to try using Lync Online again, to make sure that the problem is fixed. In this video, we've looked at how to troubleshoot problems you or your users might experience with non-functioning or poor quality audio and video in Lync Online. I hope you found it helpful. If you've tried all of the steps in this video and are still having problems, you can contact Office 365 support for more assistance.